Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meeking from Naio Nails. In this video, we are going to complete the angel design because we are going to do the wings. We are going to give the angel wings.
That's like a chicken.
Yeah. I've never got it.
That's like a bird.
Well, what does an angel do? I've got some high speed liquid, white, mega white. It's not just white, it's mega white. I'm going to wipe over my nails with some gel residue wipe off solution. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the wings coming off here onto the nails. So the stoned angel that we figured out is not male or female, it's going to have its lovely wings. We're going to give you wings. Okay? You can have wings. You're made of stone, so you can't fly. So when you're doing wings, the sort of leaves. Leaves? They're not leaves. Oh, my God. Feathers. The feathers are layered, aren't they? So you have to start at the bottom and work your way up. Yeah? So what I'm going to do is map out with some wet acrylic. So we're going to come up here, that's where the top's going to be. So I'll map out the top, but I'm not going to actually do anything with that. So it's just going to be the top area of the wing. I just need a rough idea so I can make sure that the composition of the wing is placed correctly. Do for now. And then we're going to come down to the bottom so you can see now that's where the wing is going to be. And what I'm going to do is come and do the bottom part. So like I say, you're going to start at the bottom. And you want like this little gap here. See? Because when you press into the product, it will move down. And you're going to press in to create the little dents of the feathers. To make it look textured. So we've got the first layer here. And we're going to do these next ones here. So you're going to start where they finish and then you will overlap. I'm going to turn my hand around and try to pull each section like this so you are overlapping. You're going to overlap with each layer. So still continuing the same tier of feathers. Overlapping. So this is very similar to pressing in petals. And we're just overlapping as we go. I'm going to do this all the way up right to the top. What I'm going to do now is exaggerate the outside, because that's sort of where, I don't know if there's like a bone there or, and that's a more prominent bit really, I suppose, just a little bit more definition there. I'm going to do this exactly the same basically on this nail as well. So now my wings are done, we're going to add detail with the hand painting. So we will be using polycolour. We've got titanium white and we've got black. I'm going to use some backing paper from a sculpting form as my palette. And do you know what I need to do? I need to move this acrylic liquid because I will start dipping my brush in it. Oh, we're knocking things off. I will need some white. I'm gonna mix a wash as I drag that and see what your wash is gonna look like. So as I'm mixing it, I'm pressing this part of the brush into it as well. See? So you can really see what it's gonna be like. So we're going to go in here, add some shading, The acrylic will act a bit like a sponge and it will suck up the paint. So it'll suck up the wash quite easily. If you think it's not dark enough, you can always layer it up and add a little bit more around the bottom edge, and then I'm going to sweep up like this to really exaggerate those feathers. I'm going to go into each sort of layer of feathers and add a little bit of shading there as well. I've got hardly any on my brush, I haven't got a lot. It's a lot easier to add more than it is to take it off. So not only is it going to exaggerate the feathers, it will also make it look more like stone. If there's any paint on there you don't want there, just get your brush that's dampened with monomer, so your 3D brush, and rub that across wherever it is that you want to get off. Just going to water this down a little bit more, and then just rub my brush across just to make it look more worn. I like that. I could watch that all day.
It's like you can imagine like a cartoon playing in the background of it.
Ah,
you know what I mean?
Yeah, like, them thingies. Yeah. And I'm going to do the same to this one as well. What I'm going to do on some of them is draw some of the tiny little lines that would appear on the feathers. With the white, just going to add some tiny bits of highlight. I'm going to seal that with brush on glue. It'll add a slight shine to it. It'll seal the paint in, but it won't take away the effect of the 3D. If you went over the top with top coat, it would diminish the 3D. Let that dry. And the last thing we're going to do, it's not the last actually, there's two more things to do. One is snow, one is bling. Two things, snow and bling. So for your snow, you will need mega white. You will need snow white from the Urban Graffiti gel polish range. Make sure your brush on glue is dry before you do this bit, else you will completely ruin your wings. Need a bit of shading there. As I look at it on camera, I think, needs a bit of shading. Just with the wash. A little bit of snow white. Right, we're going to do snow. I want a bit of snow here. Going to put some snow on the top of the wings here. Don't forget the little dots, the little tiny snowflakes. And then I am going to absolutely cover this with white acrylic powder. Literally let it snow all over. Let it sink in. Tap off the excess. Pop it in the lamp. And I'm going to do the same on this one and add some snow detail. Now for bling. So for the bling, we're going to use Mega Gloss. Just drizzle the Mega Gloss where you want it. And I'm just going to press the stones into the Mega Gloss and then pop that into the lamp. So I'm going to finish with some cuticle oil on all of them and just show you how fantabulous and beautiful these are. Do you know what? I think I need to say hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Do you know there's a period of time where you can't say hallelujah?
Really?
Yeah. My girls have taught me that. You can only say it, I think, once Easter's finished. Once he's risen from the... Yeah, then you can go, hallelujah. It is a very, very beautiful set and I'm very happy because I get to wear them. Nee, 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 nee. Oh, I'm putting my Christmas tree up this Sunday. I'm so excited. I must share with you my Christmas tree. I think by the time Adam's edited this, I'll have my tree up and I'll able to show you a picture of my Christmas tree. But I do want to do a whole thing inspired by my Christmas tree.
Oh, right, okay.
Because it's a bit different.
It's not. I'm coming to your house to film
it. It's not like a normal Christmas tree. Well, I don't think it is. It's a Christmas tree, granted, but it has other things on. Think back to last year. So there you are. I hope you have enjoyed watching all of my videos to do with the beautiful angel nails. I like them. Somebody said it looked like Jesus. I can see it. I can see Jesus.
Oh, Jesus had a beard.
Ah, he's had a shave. There you are, guys. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram and my Snapchat, which is Kirsty Nails. And all the products that I've used today and in the other videos are all listed below for you to see. Love you. Thank you for watching. I'll see you soon. Merry Christmas. It's Christmas time coming. Bye-bye.
Because the wings aren't part of their arms.
No, they're not. Well, I can't. Imagine I have wings. Can you like superimpose some wings? Let's get cracking. La 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 la